Hi, this is Bennett Tchaikovsky, and welcome to Financial Statement Ratios, Part 4, Coverage and Leverage Ratios. The information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only, and not of the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College, the South Orange County Community College District, or Chapman University. The presentation is for educational purposes only, and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. The presentation is copyright 2019 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. I encourage you to share this presentation and share links to the presentation on an unmodified basis. If you do modify the presentation in any way, please email me prior to doing so at bennett1812@gmail.com to discuss. Note, the author does not claim any copyright whatsoever in any companies or organizations mentioned in this presentation. The other parties are the owners of their own respective copyrights. So again, I want to give a huge shout out to Investopedia, which gave me the majority of the definitions I'm using for this presentation. One of my former IVC students, and I'm sure you're all tired of hearing about this, but because she spent time on Investopedia, when she went in to get her investment banking internship as a transfer student, which is near next to impossible, she's the unicorn, it was because of Investopedia. So Investopedia, thank you, and thank you for educating our students around the world. So we're gonna focus lastly here with our ratios as part four, which are the coverage ratios. And the coverage ratios are really here is essentially to determine the company's ability to service debt. And so we've got one here, which is our interest coverage ratio or times interest earned. Essentially here, the more profit a company generates, the greater its ability to pay down interest. So if a company has debt or is planning on taking on debt, you really want to know with its earnings, will it be able to cover the interest that's being paid on that debt? Another coverage ratio here, but we're not going to really explore, is the debt service coverage ratio. It's similar to the one above, but if beyond interest, if there's also principal repayments being made, this is a ratio to help us kind of see how much the ability to cover not only the interest expense, but also any types of principal repayments. Lastly, we have here is our asset coverage ratio, and it can help us with determining a company's long-term profit potential. The asset coverage ratio is our total assets minus any intangible assets. And I would really kind of focus here on goodwill minus current liabilities minus short-term debt obligations divided by the total debt outstanding. Lastly, we have here our leverage ratios, and here we have our debt to equity ratio tells us how much debt a company is using to finance its assets relative to the value of shareholders' equity. Remember, assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity. This ratio is really telling us what is that ratio of liabilities to equity. The debt ratio is a portion of a company's assets that are financed by debt. And so here we're taking our total debt divided by the total assets to come up with our debt ratio. And so I'm just going to pause real quick and we'll be back in a minute with our companies and going through those calculations. And here we are again. So with our first ratio, which is our interest coverage ratio, what we're doing here is we're taking our earnings before interest and taxes and dividing this by interest expense. So our interest before earnings and taxes for the Home Depot for the year ended January 28th, 2018 was right over here. We have our, right here, our earnings, or we've got our operating income. And so what I'm really gonna do here is it's really before interest and taxes. So I'm gonna take this 14,681, I'm going to add in the 74,000, and this is going to be giving me 14.7 billion. So again, I'm trying with the interest coverage is, do I have that ability to cover that or this times interest earned? Do I have this ability to cover my my interest payments? So here I've got earnings before interest and taxes of 14.7 billion. My interest expense is 1 billion. And so my interest or my time's interest earned is almost at 14. So I have pretty good coverage. If I looked here at Lowe's, Lowe's had operating income of 6.5 billion. They had no interest income. I think they netted it all out. So if we look over here at Lowe's, so we've got 6.586 billion before interest and taxes. So we've got right over here, about 6.586 billion divided by 633 million, which represents their interest amount. I'm gonna go right through here and then come up with that number of being about 10.4 billion. As I was going back and looking at this, I noticed here a loss on extinguishment of debt of $464 million. What I might wanna do is to see, was that actually a cash outlay or was that more of an accounting entry? So I may want to go through and research that a little bit more if I was really truly doing these ratios the proper way, but we're kind of more kind of taking this at a little bit of a larger glance. So right over here, I've got about 10.4. If I did include that 484 loss or that 464 loss, what would end up happening is if I just say took it here, my times interest earned is now jumping down to about 9.67. So it doesn't really make too much of a difference. So really within 10%. So we're just gonna be kind of leaving this here. Lastly, our friends at Facebook, which is again, the ratio of here of earnings before any kind of interest or taxes is really about 20.5 billion. And here, this is interest income, so we're not going to subtract this. What we're really looking at is interest expense. But what we notice about Facebook is Facebook has no debt. They've got 10.1 billion in liabilities, and they have no debt. So do these coverage ratios really apply? Not necessarily. However, if Facebook did want to borrow money, what a loan officer would probably do instead of saying no problem, what they would probably want to go through and do is to really kind of figure out, it's like, okay, how much debt could they take on? Okay. The next one here, so that's interest coverage or times interest earned. The next one here I did was the asset coverage ratio. And for this one here, this again is telling us, you know, what is our ability here to cover our debts. And let's just go back to that definition really quickly. Helps with determining a company's long-term profit potential. And so here we're going to take our total assets minus our intangible assets minus the current liabilities minus the short-term debt obligations. And so I'll just walk you through one of these right here. So this part right here, the total assets of 28 billion, what I did here is I said that Home Depot has 44.5 billion of total assets. I subtracted out the intangible assets of Home Depot, which here were, they have goodwill of 2.275 billion. So I subtracted that out. And once I subtracted out 2.275 billion, and then I deducted current liabilities, which is about 16.1 billion. But what I did though was, is I, from this, you have to kind of add back that short-term debt. And for the Home Depot, they have here short-term debt in terms of, right here, they've got, they've got short-term debt of 1.5 billion. And then they have current installments of long-term debt of 1.2 billion. In addition, they've got 24.2 billion in terms of long-term debt. So really what I did was I took this away from the equation, and then I'm dividing this by the total amount of debt outstanding. So if you look at Home Depot, they're pretty heavily leveraged, but one of the things we talked about before in the earlier presentations, what makes Home Depot very unique is they've used $48.1 billion to repurchase their own shares. And what's kind of crazy, if we think about the Home Depot stock price as of right now, And let's see here. Let's go here to Home Depot stock price, and we'll find this on the last one. So my Home Depot stock price was $179.58. And if I said to myself, okay, what if Home Depot sold 622 million shares at its current share price of $179.58? What would happen to Home Depot's cash, theoretically, if they could go through and actually pull that off? So if I took the share price of $179.58 and I multiplied it by the treasury shares for Home Depot of roughly, well, this is as of, you know, what is it? This is as of January 28, 2018. That number is even higher now, or 622 million shares. So if I multiply these two dollar amounts together, and this is Home Depot's current share price, that would amount to probably some kind of crazy Google number that, wow, holy guacamole. Wow, okay. So yeah, there you go. Home Depot is worth this. Okay. I'm not sure if that would actually happen in terms of, wow, this is like billions, trillions, and I can't even say that one. So if they took 622 million shares and you multiplied it by this, they're doing okay. So let's go back here, and I've probably done this incorrectly, and somebody will email me and say that Tchaikovsky, you're crazy, which is great. Okay, so let's go back over here to our leverage. But again, what's different about Home Depot, or the asset coverage, excuse me, what's different about them is right here is that they, you know, what's very odd is that they've gone out and they've bought about $48.1 billion back of their own stock. If we go to Lowe's, and this is what we came up with here for Lowe's, their total debt outstanding is $15.5 billion of long-term debt plus the short-term of $1.13 billion plus $294 million. And doing the same calculation here to get to $23.3 billion, which is that total assets minus the intangible assets. So let's just go over here and look at this real quick. So they've got goodwill of $1.3 billion. So you take that out. You take out the current liabilities less the other short-term debt you just included in here. You get about $1.372. And we go back to Facebook. And Facebook here is that if you take out their intangible assets, Facebook has total assets of roughly $84.5 billion. They've got a goodwill of $18.2 billion. And then if you went further and took out their intangibles, you know, you're looking at roughly about $62.5 billion. Okay. So, but again, this asset coverage isn't really going to apply to Facebook, and it's mainly because they don't have debt. We're not really concerned about them because they don't have debt outstanding now. So the next company we're going to look at is, or the next ratio we're going to look at, is debt to equity. And here's where Home Depot gets really crazy. Home Depot has total liabilities of $43 billion, but they only have shareholders' equity of $1.54 billion. Let me just make sure I got this right. Yeah, $1.45 billion of total shareholders' equity. So their debt to equity is crazy high. But again, why is it like this? They've gone out and repurchased a lot of their shares and they've made a lot of money on them, or if they were to turn around and resell it. So the other part here for Lowe's is that Lowe's right here has about $29 billion of debt or of liabilities, excuse me, and they've got about $5.8 billion of shareholders' equity, or a number here that's roughly about five. If this number here, if we didn't deduct the treasury stock for Home Depot, this number would be closer to one. But in our accounting rules, that's something we have to do. For Facebook, when we look at Facebook, they have right here total liabilities of $10.1 billion, and they have total shareholders' equity of $74 billion. So their number right here in terms of debt to equity is, you know, below one, which really means is, would somebody be willing to come along and loan Facebook money? Sure. But does Facebook need any kind of money? I think Facebook is doing great. They seem to be doing just fine. So they have $48.5 billion in current assets. They're okay. So let's go ahead and take a look at, lastly, the debt ratio. So let's go in reverse here. So Facebook has zero in terms of debt right over here. So it's really not applicable to Facebook. When we're doing the debt ratio, we're taking the total debt and dividing it by total assets. Here for Lowe's, it's about, they've got debt of about $16.9 billion from our calculation above. We're dividing that by total assets, about $35.2 billion or about 0.48. Here, the total debt to total assets is roughly about 0.61. But again, because of the treasury stock of this $48 billion, meaning stock we've repurchased, if this was in fact called an asset, you'd be looking at a completely different company. But that's why when we go through and do financial statement analysis, it's very, very important for us to remember that we have to be looking at the facts and circumstances and also be looking at, well, what else is happening here in terms of determining a company's true financial picture. So I want to thank you for joining the presentation today. Please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you have any feedback, please send it to 1812cpa@gmail.com or bennett1812@gmail.com. Have a great one, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care.